Ben, happiness coach and the author of Get in a Good Mood and Stay There, is here to talk about the dangers of loneliness. Well, we all know Virginia Beach's own Pharrell Williams is happy. In fact, it's the official song of Virginia Beach. But it turns out, according to a recent BBC study, a third of all people said they were lonely. So our next guest says loneliness can actually be deadly. Danny DeNovo is a happiness coach and author of the bestseller, Get in a Good Mood and Stay There. Welcome to Coast Live.
Thank you.
What a good time for you to be here.
I know. There's going to be a lot of people struggling in the next few weeks.
Yeah.
And being alone and being isolated.
Exactly. Okay, so you have a loneliness test, right?
I do. I have a little quiz for everyone.
Okay.
So, number one, do you feel like you spend too much time by yourself? And do you not enjoy being by yourself?
Right? Okay.
Okay, number two, do you feel lonely even when you are around people? So you're around people all the time, but you still kind of have this lonely feeling in the back.
Okay, am I supposed to be taking it myself too?
You can, yes.
Okay, all right.
Feel free to answer.
No.
Okay, all right, good, that's good. Number three, do you have a hard time making new friends?
Not really, but I'm kind of leaving it, you know, kind of like my friends.
Well, right now,
already have.
Yeah, right. Yeah, we're not making new friends right now.
Yeah.
But have you lost touch with old friends?
No, not really. Mm-mm.
That's good. And do you feel like you have people around you that you can share your life's events with? That's really the question.
Yes.
Okay. Do you feel cut off from your family or from your community in any way?
Well, a little bit now.
Right, everyone,
you know,
is.
Because we have church and I'm used to seeing everybody on Sunday and shaking hands and hugging, and now we can't even, you know, we can say hi on social media.
The separation is hard, but really what I'm more worried about is that you have someone to go to, especially in this time, if you feel you need help.
Okay.
Right.
Yeah.
And the people that you are around, that you do spend time with, do you feel like you don't have very much in common with those people?
No, I don't feel that way.
That's a good sign.
Okay.
And then the last one is, do you spend more time, you know, at home with your robot cleaner?
Oh, wow.
Watching Netflix, talking to Alexa, than you do actually connecting with real people? And this is going to be a real test for everyone coming up here.
Yeah. No, I'm still interacting with a good deal of people.
Well, that's great.
Yeah.
Because if you have one, yes, you know, you're just a human being. Everyone's a little bit lonely or distanced from time to time.
Mm-hmm.
Two yeses and you might be in a little bit of danger. But three yeses, you might, you know, your loneliness might be actually killing you physically.
Wow. Okay, now that sounds extreme. I mean, we're used to hearing, you know, diseases and cancer and different things like that could kill you, but we're not used to hearing loneliness. How does that work?
I know it's startling to think that a common human feeling like loneliness can be so dangerous, but it actually is a killer. It is as harmful to our health as smoking 15 cigarettes a day, and it increases our risk of developing dementia and Alzheimer's, high blood pressure, heart disease, all kinds of chronic diseases. So that mind-body correlation when it comes to loneliness is real, and something that we're gonna have to pay attention to while we're being socially distanced and quarantined.
Wow, that's really incredible to hear those statistics. So people need to take this seriously.
They should, yes. Yeah. And, you know, I think it's sometimes we have this false sense of connecting over things like social media. So it's going to be really important that, you know, if you can't be with family or with friends, that you're having really good real-time conversations, even if it's over the phone. If you can't do video, that's fine. But having really good conversations where you're listening to one another and connecting on a deeper level.
I have a really interesting question for you. So there are people who do this on purpose. They're called Gen Z. Okay, so what about them that are actually making these decisions to, you know, not make as many friends, be social, be on Netflix, be on social media? Can they succumb to the same, you know, result?
I think they can. Okay. I think it's really a personal choice. But what I would say is you really have to be tuned in to who you are and how you're feeling. If you're spending time alone and you're feeling good and you're happy and you have limited interaction, then you're probably okay. But if you find yourself sort of lamenting the fact that you're alone, feeling sad, wishing that someone was around, then you probably need to have more interaction.
Okay, good to know. Okay, so how can we get happy?
You can get happy by my acronym, HAPPY.
Okay.
So the H is hitch yourself to new ideas, new groups, new activities. I know that's gonna be a little bit hard right now, but there's a lot of things we can do online. online, even socially. Mm-hmm. So keep those interactions going right now. A is for just appreciate the good all around you. This is just good old-fashioned gratitude. You can take 3 minutes in the morning when you wake up and find something good about the day. If you look for it, you can find it.
Okay.
The first P is prize yourself. This is a great time to really get to know yourself again and learn to really love yourself, because if you like yourself, then you don't mind spending time alone with yourself.
Got it.
And the second P stands for purpose. I think having a purpose in life is a real game changer. This is a great time to do a little soul searching and figure out what that is. I went through a very bad depression in my life, and I was cooking dinner on the stove one night, and I was stirring the pot, and my daughter was sitting on the floor. She was just a baby, but she picked up a pot that she was playing with and a spoon, and she started mimicking what I was doing.
Oh.
And at first I thought, oh, that's so cute. She's just like mommy. But then I just had this wave of nausea hit me, because I realized she was copying everything that I was doing.
Right.
And she was going to learn how to be depressed and lonely just like mom, because I was teaching her those things.
Right.
So my purpose became learning how to be happy and fulfilled so I could teach that to her and then teach it to others.
Okay. And the why is you.
The why is you, because you're the only one that can change your loneliness into happiness and the only one that can stop your loneliness from killing you.
Wow. Well, thank you so much for bringing this information to us at a time like this. And where can we get a copy? Your book.
You can find my book online. It's on Amazon, and it's also on my website at DannyDeNovo.com.
Danny, thank you. I think we're going to bring you back.
Thank you, April.
Thanks so much.